tomorrow, it'll all come together, and I think you'll agree that the RX is unlike any RX that we have had previously. So as Brian mentioned, two offerings, the RX 350 and the RX 450H, all-wheel drive and front-wheel drive, with the addition of S-Port made available on both of those models. I'd like to show the design concept, because one of the things I think is very true is that the concept kind of came to life, which is nice to see. You can see here very bold, expressive lines, character lines on the side, large wheels, tires, and that floating roof line. From the front, again, that bold, aggressive Lexus signature spindle grille, giving much more presence to the RX. The design theme was seductive strength. Again, using the DNA of the RX, wanted to add some sort of sexiness into the vehicle, again, making it more expressive and giving a greater presence to the vehicle on the road. So the concept doesn't look too different from the vehicle itself, which is nice to see. So up front, you can see the large spindle grille. The fold points on the portion of the grille actually are wider than the lower portion, so again, giving much more presence. And as Brian mentioned, kind of gives the non-export vehicle almost an export look to the car. Daytime running lights are LEDs in that arrowhead-shaped design, again, L-shaped inspired, as well as LED fog lamps. As you move to the side of the vehicle, the floating roof line is probably the most unique. First time seeing that on a Lexus vehicle. It's hemmed by a chrome. And also the character lines that run down the side of the vehicle. Actually, from the front all the way to the rear, that continues basically to the vehicle, carrying the spindle theme to the back. The lower portion rocker panel, actually that flare up to the rear wheel, is something you've seen recently with our IS and our NX model. So again, kind of that the design language continuing. And large wheels finishing the package. At the back, the LED taillights, again, kind of actually extend from the side of the vehicle, giving it a greater presence from the rear as well. So it complements the front all the way to the rear. One of the nice things too is that the RX 350 features dual exhaust on the vehicle, adding a premium look to the vehicle and a sporty, aggressive look. And this is shown in the S-Port, but the regular RX 350 does indeed have dual exhaust. The hybrid would have a concealed exhaust, as we've done with several of our other hybrid vehicles. So up front, LED headlamps are standard. They're bi-LED using a single projector beam. And then the fog lamps housed in that arrow casing is actually LEDs as well. We do offer an upgrade if you're familiar. You've seen several of our models offering the triple beam LEDs, so that L-shaped icon, and also the daytime running lights and fog lamps with the addition of cornering lamps. So with steering input, that cornering lamp, that LED lamp will actually turn on, increasing visibility. In addition, with these lamps, there's also concealed headlamp washers. At the rear, as I mentioned, LED rear combination lamps. With the premium package or the premium headlamps, you'll see that the turn signal indicator goes to an LED. Previously on the non-upgrade, it's a bulb in that section there. The tail lamps themselves actually, as I said, extend from the side of the vehicle, wrap around the side, kind of giving it more presence. But even just the look of them, it was referred to as kind of like a cracked ice. So again, a three-dimensionality to that design. I think you'll find it very expressive. Dimensionally, the car has gotten bigger. The yellow overlay is showing what the current generation RX looks like compared to the 2016. Wheelbase is increased by 1.9 inches. Overall length is 4.7, almost 5 inches longer, with the majority of that being to the front overhang. So the vehicle has more of a rear wheel drive kind of look to it by having this increased overhang up front and has a sense of motion. Overall height of the vehicle stays the same at 67.7 inches. Width is increased by 0.4 inches. One of the things researchers found was customers or owners of Lexus, the RX, love the packaging, the size of the vehicle, the maneuverability. So they didn't want, you know, they liked what it was, but of course they want more room. So Katsuda-san and his engineers were able to actually maximize the interior space on the vehicle. So shoulder room and hip room. Actually, hip room is increased 1.1 inch up front and 1.5 in the rear. And then leg room has increased up front 1 inch and then 1.2 inches in the rear. With that increased wheelbase, adding more comfort to the rear seat compartment. Headroom, 0.3 and 0.4 inches front and rear, so a little bit more in headroom. Now, it wouldn't be a Lexus if it wasn't quiet, so a lot of enhancements. continue to make use of acoustic front window glass. There's a cowl silencer that's been added, as well as a resin dampening in the floor, as well as a variety of other things. Now, this, of course, wasn't just kind of a blanket of just throwing stuff at it. It was strategically placed, you know, to enhance and control noises that may emanate from the cabin. Aerodynamics also enhances the quietness and the handling of the vehicle. So up front, you'll notice there's a lower front bumper, which is kind of unique for the RX. In the current generation RX, you have to go to an S4 to have that kind of lower bumper chin spoiler. The standard RX features that. We'll see that tomorrow in person. Also, the rear spoiler angles have been changed, as well as the corner fin on that, again, enhancing aerodynamics, as well as that, the addition of aero-stabilizing fins on the rear tail lamps. Even the rear bumper angle has been optimized as well, so air flows above and below. So again, to make this vehicle fun to drive, exciting, more engaging, had to start with some tuning goals. One of them was enhanced responsiveness with minimal body roll, also adding confident steering, and then of course making sure that it was a comfortable ride because it is a Lexus and it's an RX. So the design, the engineering team first started by changing the engine mount positions. When you think of it, an engine is this large mass that can kind of work against you. It's not properly housed within the engine compartment and within the vehicle. So countermeasures are made to not only reduce vibration, but also to increase the rigidity connection to the engine to the body. One of the engine mounts, and actually it would be the one on your left, was actually mounted to the body, so reducing lateral movements. So again, trying to stop that engine from being the inertia of when you're accelerating, of having that engine just kind of work against you when you're trying to enhance the drive capabilities of this vehicle. Up front, we're using Pearson Strut front suspensions. The stabilizer bar has actually been increased to 28.6 millimeters. It's a hollow tube, whereas previously it was a 26 millimeter solid. With those enhancements, the stabilizer bar bushings were also increased. And so again, the idea was to increase the handling of the vehicle, but also ride comfort was a priority. So with those, we were able to actually soften the spring rates. At the rear, it's a double wishbone rear suspension. The coil spring and shock absorber are separated like they currently are. Again, that allows for maximum cargo capacity in the rear of the vehicle. We've gotten used to that. The arm bushing rigidity was enhanced in that. And as a result, we have a firm rear suspension, but also a comfortable ride and great steering. Moving into the vehicle, the rigidity, Katsuda-san and his team looked at areas of opportunity to increase the stability of the vehicle. So they straightened the cowl ridge line. So again, adding that structural rigidity and enhancing control of the vehicle. Also using annular frame construction, they strengthened the frame joint rigidity in those key areas on the sides of the vehicle, as well as the deck board stay. Again, controlling the lateral motions and tightness of the vehicle. And the rear body frame construction is also enhanced. With the addition of that though, there's now aluminum hood and rear door. That's the first first application of aluminum hood and rear door in a North American produced vehicle. As Brian said, this is being built in TMMC in Canada. Then just looking a little further in, the cross member behind the cowl has actually been increased and it connects to the front pillar gusset, the A pillar. So again, enhancing that rigidity and ultimately the handling of the vehicle's capabilities. As well as we've seen this before, the RX gets use of technology we first started seeing in the IS. So we have body adhesive laser screw welding and additional spot welds in key areas. So again, for the vehicle to be as fun to drive or enhanced driving capability, all these additions were made to the 2016 RX. Up front, the brakes are 12.9 disc brakes, and the rear are 13.3, with the addition of now an electric parking brake. To the RX. So we've seen this happening in several of our vehicles. Again, freeing up the space in the center console area. And automatic brake bolt has also been added to the RX as well. Wheels, standard wheels, an 18-inch seven-spoke wheel here. Previously, the largest wheel that was offered on an RX was a 19, but now we have a variety of 20-inch wheels, again, adding to the look of the vehicle. This one is a machine high-gloss wheel. You'll see an example of this tomorrow on several of the vehicles. But with the luxury package, it has its own unique wheel. It's standard is an Insidian insert, but there are customizable trim inserts, so customers can take that vehicle and make it more of their own. Offered in silver, white, and autumn shimmer, which are colors available on the RX itself. Also, during the development of the vehicle, Michelin was a key partner of ours. So Michelin is actually utilizing our Evergrip technology, and it actually has grooves that, as the tire wears, those grooves increase. And basically, as they say, it's safe when new and it's safe when worn. Our friends from Michelin will be over at the Colony tomorrow, so we'll be able to actually spend more time with you and actually show you samples of that as the tire wears, how the grooves reveal themselves, enhancing the capability of that. Unfortunately, the mascot for Michelin couldn't make it without the selfies with it.